Hey guys, what's up? Now that the decision-making process is all finished and I need to start working on getting all of my cells put into packs. So I started thinking, I got several different projects. I have my power wall and I want to do an upgrade of my portable power pack, my big one. And I was wanting to build some smaller power packs, but I was kind of torn. I got too many projects. So I decided that for now, because I'm still processing cells for my power wall, I'm gonna let that be. I do have cells completed where I can actually go in and I'm gonna do an upgrade to my portable power pack, and that's what we're gonna get started on. Probably gonna be a 2, maybe 3-part series because there's just a lot of work to do. So we're just gonna do it right now. So stay tuned. So the first part of this is I needed to strip out all of the wiring and my inverter and get things prepped. So I'm going to pull out these three cell banks, these three separate batteries that I've built out of 18650 cells, and I'm going to take those and I'm going to upgrade them to this. So not exactly like this, but what I want to do is actually have three of these in here. And you're looking, well, that didn't change a whole lot. Well, it did, because these are a lot more cells in comparison to what was in there, each of these banks. So I'm gonna have three cell blocks like this instead of just three like this. It's actually twice the cells. If you look here, if you were to stack these, there's actually two of these in each one of these bricks. So basically I'm doubling the capacity. I have more cells now, so I can do that. Plus I did some checking and my inverter fits, or my electronics fit just above this, so there's plenty of room. I will need to get some longer straps because I strapped these in, so my straps need to be longer, but that's not a problem. I can get strapping pretty cheap. And from there, I just got to work out how I'm going to wire the whole thing up, but we'll get to that in a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and start processing these cells. This was just an example pack. And to do that, I'm going to be using this stuff here. So if I have two of these, so I got one kit here, one here, and then I'm going to use these other cells along with this to create my third cell pack. So I'll have the three cell packs that will go back into the case and we will have double the capacity. So that should put me right around about four kilowatts of power. So it's quite a bit. And the reason I'm also doing this, you remember my question and answer, my question videos, I was talking about, should I put my cells all in these packs together, you know, where we do them in parallel and serial. So this is going to create, I had them at 12 volts. These were running three of these, you get 12 volts, but I had decided to add another to go to 16. One of the reasons is because 12 volts was the top end of this, and I don't want to drive my cells all the way to the top. So I'm going to do this in a 16 volt, and I'll run it up to about 14 volts. Turns out that my inverter can handle 15.5 volts. So this will not have a problem, and I will not overcharge these. So they're going to go up to about the 15 volt mark. 15.5, I think, is where I'm going to drive them to. And then the other thing is the devices that hang out the front, you know, like the USB port and the power ports, these can actually handle up to 24 volts. And so this isn't going to be a problem for this to be able to handle out of the power pack. So I'm actually hoping this will work better. I'm thinking it will, because of the fact that it's just so much more efficient to run higher voltage than it is to run right at, you know, max volt is 12 volts, and I didn't really like that. So going with four cell packs in each one of these bricks. The other reason I'm doing it this way as well, and I'll have them in groups of three, is so that at any point in time, I can actually remove one of these and the kit stays running. I can, you know, my power pack, I can still use it. It's still a usable device, and I can replace them. So if I need to take one of these out for maintenance, I'm not down. I have less amperage, but I still have capacity, but I still have the voltage that I need to do what I need. And then, like I said, I can do maintenance, pull them in and out. So anyways, let's start tearing these down, because the first thing I need to do is I need to start tearing these apart so that I can put them in large packs like this. All right, I'm gonna start tearing apart these cells now, these cell blocks. So set this aside. We're gonna start first of all, I'm gonna unsolder all of my connections off my bus bars. I will be reusing my bus bars, well, not the bus bars themselves, but these in pieces, so I can use them on my new cell packs. So now I'm gonna go ahead and start disassembling these. I'm gonna put it in time lapse, so you don't have to sit and watch me the whole time, but it'll go quite a bit faster. So here we go, starting to tear it apart. Now I've gotten down to, I've got two cell packs that have been, bus bar has been removed. I got one more to go. So once I get that done, then I will continue shooting on the next step of how I will actually be kind of reharvesting these cells so that I can use them for the new cell packs and kind of intermingle them. We'll have to do some balancing in that. So let me finish this cell pack up, and then we'll start the next step of disassembling these and organizing the cells. All right, so now I've gotten my cell packs all tore apart and reintegrated. They're actually now in numerical order, starting here at cell one, the first cell I ever processed back in November of 2016. And then they just go in numeric order. Out, these are 500s and 400s and 300s, and so they're in sets of 100, and it allows me to identify them. I keep my IDs in order so that I can actually use my spreadsheet to track each cell, so I know the volume. So this one here, this specific cell here, is 2636 milliamp hours, and when I run that back into using the spreadsheet, and I go through Reprat Packer, I'll be able to determine how many or what cells go in each pack. So I'm gonna need 12 bricks of this size here, in which I'll build these four sections into three separate batteries to give me three separate batteries of 24 volts or 16 volts. And that's about where we're at, is I just had to tear these apart and then get the cells all in numeric order. I got all my pieces and parts here, and I have my old strips that I'll disassemble some pieces of that later. All right, guys, so I finished that piece of it. I'm gonna go to work on the cell packer stuff, where I'll build out the spreadsheets. I'll show you some bits and pieces of that in the next video. This one here is getting a little bit long, so I need to do some work on it. It's not complete. So we're gonna go on ahead and I'll build out the spreadsheets, I'll build out the packs, I'll have 12 packs that will be very consistent, and then we'll actually know which cells go into each pack. And then in the next video, we'll actually start assembling those packs so that they can be used. Please subscribe below, and I also encourage you, if you have questions or if there's something that you would like to see me cover that I'm not currently covering, or if you have questions about what we've done so far, please put them in the comments below. I'd be glad to look into other things that you may have an interest in. So with that, catch you next time.